my daughter. I grew up in the Midwest. Usual story. Felt different. Really didn't fit in. But I wasn't going to turn the other cheek. No siree. I started selling candy in school. Jacked up the prices several 100%. Let's see. What else? Oh. Once when I was 10, my Sunday school teacher took me back to his house. He taught me how to French kiss, among other things. His mother caught us in the basement. She screamed, "I told you not to bring them here!" And he said, "Don't, you'll frighten them away." So like any small town boy, I had big time plans. So it should come as no surprise that I ended up in New York City. One day, I realized I didn't want to have to get up in the morning and go to work. I didn't want to be like all the drearies and normals. I wanted to create my own world. A world full of color where everyone could play. One big party that never ends. We did all your drugs and we need some more.
Hi, NickNakSoWhack.
Hi, Mr. Fahrenheit.
I actually really enjoyed it. I think there is such an amazing spot for you in this competition. And what you did just proved that. It was very performance art, which I really appreciate. And I don't think everyone maybe in the audience did not appreciate, and that's okay, because when people come to this kind of competition, they don't know what they're expecting. They maybe never been to a drag show or anything like that. So you never know, but you might have opened some eyes. I knew exactly what you were doing, and I loved the hammer bit, and I loved the little monologue you had at the beginning. I thought you nailed it flawlessly. For a monologue that was done in a bed, you really worked the stage really, really well, so I commend you on that. I really thought it was great. I thought it was very different, and it was very performance art. And I want to encourage you to do that, because that's very unlike anything anyone's doing in this competition. But really make sure that you still are, like, it's like, I do a show, and if I'm doing something weird, I'm like, if I made two people gag, like, I'm okay, like, I'm fine, whatever, they fucking loved it. But with this competition, you really gotta win over this audience, because these people are gonna be there here the entire time.
Yep.
And you gotta learn how to play to them, but always stay true to yourself.
Yep.
And I want you to stay true to yourself, because you're amazing and you're a vision. So play with that. I mean, that would be my only note, because I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a great take on that whole scene. It was fantastic.
Okay.
You're adorable, party monster. That was cute. I enjoyed that, and I enjoyed wherever you get your printing done.
At home.
Really high quality.
Wait, that's the September 2011 issue.
Obviously. Yeah. No, you are super cute, and I enjoy your blue ears and like the whole thing. It's very cute. I enjoyed that a lot. And like I said, like this contest is, like I really appreciate having like somebody who's doing not like anybody else. So I enjoy that. I want to see like a tiny bit more intentionality in your movement, because you're obviously super capable of it. Because there were parts of it where you were like super on point in your face and your movement synced up all the way. And then other parts I was like, I don't know if I'm going to be able to stay with you for this part, because it seemed like you weren't invested in Ivan. So I just want consistency with that. Because when you're on. So just stay on.
Stay on. I love the uniqueness. I totally get the Michael Ealy thing. I'm into it. Fucking fantastic.
One more time for NickNakSoWhack. Stay right there, my friend. Woo!
You can stand up. You don't have to stay right there. You're adorable.
Let's get all the contestants back on stage.